Hello, my dear children. How are you all? Hope you all are fine and safe at home. Today, we are going to start with the history chapter of Standard 6. Here, on this page, you see the first one is shown the seals. On the top, there are pots, stupa of Sanchi, Ratna or chariot temples of the Mahabalipuram, gold coins of Samudragupta, Bodhisattva of Padmapani, Ajanta. Total, there are 11 chapters. We'll have first 5 for the first term. So, first chapter is on the Indian subcontinent and history. 1.1, that is history and its pillars. What is history? History is a current account of the significant past events in the progress of human civilization. 4 major pillars of history are, that is time, place, society and individuals. Geographical conditions of history. What do you mean by geographical conditions? It means the features of an area. The component, that is place, is related to geographical conditions. History and geography are inseparable. History is influenced by geographical conditions. 4th point, diet, clothing, housing, occupation, and entire human life in any region depend on its geographical conditions. Therefore, we find differences in the lifestyle of the people of the hilly regions and those of the plains. 5th, human settlements have flourished wherever the means of living are plentiful. Degradation of the environment, drought, invasions, etc. lead to the scarcity of means and people are forced to leave their settlements. 1.2, that is geographical features of India. India is a large country having Himalayas towards the north. Here, my dear children, see on the top there are Himalayas, that is to the north side. Here there is Hindu Kush Mountain, Afghanistan, Pakistan, Bolan Pass, Khyber Pass. To the east is the Bay of Bengal. To the west is the Arabian Sea. To the south is the Indian Ocean. The following regions are seen to be important when we look at the course of the Indian history. The Himalayas, the plains of the Sindhu, Ganga, Brahmaputra rivers, the Thar Desert, the Deccan Plateau, the coastal regions, the islands in the seas. The first we are going to study of Himalayas. The Hindu Kush and the Himalaya ranges have created an impenetrable wall on the northern side of the Indian subcontinent. There is a land route through the Khyber Pass and the Bolan Passes in the Hindu Kush Mountains. For this, my dear children, you have to see the map. The trade route from China passed through Central Asia and reached Arabia. It is also known as Silk Route or Silk Road, because silk was the main commodity exported to the Western countries using this road. Next is the plains of the Sindhu, Ganga, Brahmaputra. This region consists of the basins of the three big rivers, that is the Sindhu, Ganga, Brahmaputra, and the tributaries. And the later states and the empires of ancient India emerged over there. Next comes the Thar Desert. The Thar Desert spreads across Rajasthan, Haryana, and some parts of Gujarat. The desert has Satluj River to its north, the Aravalli mountain range to its east. Next is the Deccan Plateau. This region describes Deccan Plateau falls within the Indian Peninsula. Vindhya and Saputhara mountain ranges are to its north, whereas the Sahyadri mountain range is towards the west coast. Next, fifth is the coastal regions. From the time of the Harappan civilization, ancient India had trade relations with the western countries. This trade was carried on by sea, so India had developed contact and interaction with foreign cultures and people of the seaports. Sixth point, that is the islands in the sea. Andaman and Nicobar are the Indian islands in the Bay of Bengal. Lakshadweep is a group of Indian islands in the Arabian Sea. The manuscript Periplus of the Erythraean Sea or Handbook of the Red Sea makes a mention of the Indian islands. It has been written by an unknown Greek sailor. Last, the Indian subcontinent. The cities of Harappa and Mohenjo-daro are in today's Pakistan, as well as Afghanistan, Pakistan, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, and India together form the region known as South Asia. Considering the expanse and the significance of India in this region is also known as Indian subcontinent. Thank you, my students. Here is the worksheet which I'm giving to you. Solve it at home. When you come back to school, you have to bring that notebook and show it to me. Stay home, stay safe.